Thank you everybody for supporting this channel by watching videos, commenting, liking, and subscribing. It means the world to me. That being said, I recently started a second YouTube channel called Light Perpetual, where I will be showing walkthroughs of how I create uplifting trance songs. I will also be posting the completed songs as well. Thanks for all the support. Now, without further ado, let's get into tonight's ritual pastas. Note, this ritual is complex and should only be performed if you're willing to risk you and your pet's life. There are no known instances of completion that surround this ritual. It is stated to have been published in online documentation in 2007. However, the exact date of publication is unknown. For this ritual, you will need a dog, a watch with timer capabilities, 3 candles, 3 red or 3 black, a dark room, red or black string, focus. Before you begin the ritual, you will need to prepare a room of your house before midnight or 6 a.m. Your house can only have 2 presences simultaneously, you and your dog. This includes paranormal entities, so make sure previous rituals are done that can remove any present entities if possible. Make sure the room is capable of being in total darkness by covering the windows, etc. Place either a red or black string in the middle of the room, making sure it is straight. Place either black candles, if you are using red string, or red candles, if you are using black string, on each side of the string. This is to represent the bridge between the ethereal realm and the living realm. Do not light the candles yet, for safety reasons. Prepare the room so that it is pitch black inside when you leave. You will need the third candle with you when you leave the room. Wait until exactly 6/12 a.m. and light the third candle. The ritual has now begun. Make your way to the room with the lit candle in your hand, and your dog either following you or in your other arm, depending on their size. You have 6 minutes to enter the room. It is very important that you do not become distracted during those 6 minutes. You may experience the phone ringing or text alerts, etc., but ignore them. You are being contacted from the other realm. Failing to reach the room in these 6 minutes is likely to result in traumatic events to occur, possibly even death, in an unknown way. Bring your dog with you. This will only work if your dog is calm or tired enough to remain still for a short period of time. You will have 30 minutes to complete this ritual. It is unknown what happens if you do not complete it after 6:30 p.m., 12:30 a.m., or 6:30 a.m., depending on which designated time you decide to start. So it's recommended that you ensure you have everything you need before entering the room. Place your dog on one side of the string and seat yourself on the other. It does not matter which side you are on. Place the fur candle next to the one candle on your side so that you are able to light the candle on your dog's side. It is extremely important that you light your dog's candle first, as lighting yours and then your dog's could open the gateway between realms and let in enigmatic entities. When both candles are lit, extinguish the third. One of two things will happen now. Your dog will lay down and shut their eyes. This signifies that you have succeeded this step. Your dog will begin to howl or bark uncontrollably, to which you must quickly put out their candle and abort the ritual, burning the string in the process. If you succeed, set a timer on your watch for 6 minutes and close your eyes for that time. You need to use a watch. A phone will not work. Do not open them for anything. You will hear strange noises and may even feel the presence of something large in front of you. Do not open your eyes. When 6 minutes are up, open your eyes. Do not react to what you see in front of you. It'll appear to be horrifically distorted, but do not react. Your dog will look completely different now. How they change can differ between breeds of dogs. The ritual would become incredibly dangerous now if you make a mistake. You will be unable to leave the room or abort the ritual at this point. Look at the entity in front of you. You have two options. You can say,
I seek the wisdom and intelligence of the other world. Bless me with the knowledge beyond my mind.
Or,
I seek my sadness to end. Bring me happiness.
The first line summons what is believed to be God, to which you can ask him any question, and he'll answer with no metaphorical manner, just a straight up answer. Your dog will die as a result of the answer. The second line summons what is believed to be the devil, who you cannot ask anything. The devil will either kill you using the demonic disfiguration of the dog, allowing you to contact a dead relative at the cost of your dog's life, or simply watch you through the dog's eyes in silence and then disappear. This does not kill your dog. Neither God nor devil appear physically. They will contact you as though to be whispering via your dog. To end the ritual, say,
thank you for your voice.
Set an alarm to go off at 12:30 or 6:30 a.m. and shut your eyes. The ritual will end when the alarm goes off and you open your eyes. The candles will now be extinguished and your dog will be in front of you, but the outcome of their life depends on what you are gifted by the voices. You have been successfully gifted by the voice.